Hey guys, what's going on? So I apologize for not having a video yesterday. I needed to take a day off. I did a lot of live streaming this past week, and I just needed to take some little bit of time off of doing the whole YouTube thing, streaming and everything. I just want to start off by saying that, and I want to say To Be Released is back. So I know all of you are probably aware I stayed up on my last live stream to wait for this to happen, and the base form Vegeta was released in the Bomba shop. So we now have him available, and we are able to purchase up to two. So the purpose of this video is not to really go over the card too much, but more to talk about what you should do with that second card. Now, I saw a couple people saying, no, save both of them to get them up to Super Attack 20. I completely want to disagree with that statement. I think you should go bottom right. So if you're just looking for that quick answer, bottom right Dewpath is what I believe to be the best way to utilize that second Vegeta. If you want a more in-depth answer, we're going to go over that throughout the rest of this video. So what happened? On the 14th at 10:30 p.m. Pacific time, we got the base form SSR Vegito. Now, we are supposed to be getting the medals to Dokkan Awaken him at some point soon, and he will then further Dokkan Awaken into an LR. So right now, he is an SSR. So he is really not that useful for us. Let's go take a look at the card himself. Right, so we have Determined Fusion Vegito. First off, also shout out to the Dokkan Battle Wiki, dbz.space, and the Reddit. Thank you for all the information between all three of you guys. You guys are all always awesome. So, leader ability, super type, key plus 2, HP, attack, and defense plus 30%. So, as his base form, he's really not that useful unless you don't have any type of leader. other than that, that leader skill can kind of be done without until maybe we get the LR variant. His super attack raises attack and defense and causes supreme damage to the enemy. So, he's not horrible. He's actually a pretty decent unit. His passive skill is attack and defense plus 40%, and he raises key up to at least by 6. Based off of the amount of health remaining. The lower the health, the more key you get, up to 6. So I don't know what the exact numbers are on that. It's not horrible, but if you're already running a dual, like Super Saiyan 4 Goku lead or something like that, then it kind of makes it not worth it, just because you don't need it. It'll be great when he's an LR, but as he's an SSR right now, it's not really that useful. Attack and defense plus 40% means he'll at least tank a little bit better, and he'll attack a little bit better, but he's not amazing. Link skills are Saiyan Warrior Ace, Brainiacs, Power Bestowed by God, Prepared for Battle, and Fused Fighter. Not that horrible, not that great. It's very limited selection for some of these, like Power Bestowed by God and Brainiacs. But at least he does have Prepared for Battle and Fused Fighter, which are pretty decent, though they're only the key links. His max stats at Ultra Rare are HP of 58,000, attack of 76,000, and defense of almost 4,000. If you do the base dupe system, it's HP of 78,000, attack of 96,000, and defense of almost 6,000. He has a 12 key multiplier of 135%. At 100% HP, Vegito will give himself 1 key. Under 60% and 50% HP, Vegito gives himself 3 key. Interesting. When performing a super, Vegito raises his own attack and defense by 20% for the rest of the match. Kaioken mechanic. Oh, okay, so that can stack. So he actually ends up being a really powerful unit. I didn't realize that there was a Kaioken mechanic. I'm doing this live with you guys right now. He will Dokkan Awaken at some point with the Katara fusions. I don't know if we have any information. Okay, we do have more information. I'm not going to go over it too much. Let's just go take a real quick look. Raises attack and defense, supreme damage. His passive skill will become attack and defense with 60%, which is really awesome. Raises key up to 8. Then he gets Shattering the Limit. His max base stats are... Or max base dupe system stats are HP of 93,000, attack of 10,000, almost 11,000, and defense of 6,800. He has a 12 key multiplier of 140%. I guess we don't have any other information about it. So overall, why do I say the bottom right Dewpath? Well, I did some math on the calculator, and this is some very basic stuff. It's not taking into consideration link skills, anything like that. It's literally taking in his Dewpath and or his buff, his actual 30% buff that all LRs seem to get. So I based the math off of this, right? You have the bottom right Dewpath, which typically gives a 1700 attack buff to the unit, right? It's typically a flat out 1700 attack buff, attack, HP, defense, something like that. Usually sometimes mix between them, one's a little bit higher, one's a little bit lower, depending on the type of unit that it is. But overall, we're going to go with the 1700 buff, because I'm pretty sure that's what he gets. With that 1700 buff, you also get the three different dupes that you can get. Typically, we'll give two of those are going to be crit, and one of them is going to be a double attack. Regardless of what you choose, he's going to get a 1700% attack buff. Now, based off of the other LRs in game, now these are all the LRs on the global side, all of them, when you get them up to super attack 20, they get a 30% attack buff, right, to their supers, only their supers. which is typically pretty awesome. 30%, 30%, 30%. I want to, even the free-to-play units, they've always gotten 30% attack buffs. Now, when you factor in the 30% attack buff on top of the multiplier, let's just say a 2.4 multiplier for the 120 leads, just saying you have 120. I also did on the 150 leads. It doesn't close the gap a significant amount. It like knocks off 2,000 points. You will do an additional like couple thousand. Actually, let's see, 23,700 damage if you're doing the 1.3 multiplier for the 30% attack buff on the super attack. If you go and you add the 1,700, that 23,700, or if you could just round it up, the 24,000 goes to 27,100, or we could round that down to 27,000. So that is what? That's a 4,000 attack buff just for doing the bottom right dupe path instead of doing super attack 20. Now, again, we don't know what his LR stats are going to be, but that's just the way to do it. I also did a little bit more with like the 1.5 multiplier, stuff like that. But it's consistently going to be different. I even doubled his base stats to make it like an LR. So I did a 21,700 base stat with the bottom right dupe path unlock as compared to the 15,000 what it would be if it was like almost double with just the dupe path without the dupe path unlock at him at super attack 20. It comes out to about a 6,000 point difference with a 1.4 or I'm sorry, 120 lead. So multiply by about 2.4. So overall, stats are better bottom right. Now, what else, what other reasoning can I have for talking about this right now? Well, let's go ahead and show you right here. I know all of you are probably aware. Some of you guys are privy to this. Some of you may not be. We are going to be getting the physical Super Vegito at some point in the future. We don't know when. I would guess about another 2.5 months we'll probably get him. Again, I don't know the exact date, but that's just an estimate on my part. Now, let's take a look. This event over here, level 1 Miraculous Fusion from Supreme Fusion, the Batara event, it drops this base form Vegito, full force power Vegito. This is not the same Vegito as this one. These are two different Vegitos. Let me drag this comparison. So these two are completely different. But this one is farmable, and he drops as an SR, and he will dope an old Z Awaken into an SSR. I'm pretty sure he just drops as an SSR, though. No guarantees there. I'll open that up. Back here. Yeah, he drops as an SSR. So right off the bat, you could farm him, this one, up to Super Attack 10 with this one without any issue. If for any reason you want to get him up to Super Attack 10, then use Elder Kai's on him. But the bottom right dupe path is always the way to go when comparing Super Attack 10 or Super Attack 20 with bottom right dupe path. I mean, if you know of any other reason why we should not be doing the bottom right, please let me know in the comments below and I will retract the video. And I will do a follow-up video explaining as to why. But as of now, there is no reason for you to save both of them and just do the bottom right dupe path, because then you can get the bottom right dupe path open with more attack and you get those different crits and stuff. Again, this is all under the assumption that we are not going to get any additional ones. We don't know if it's going to renew. We don't know if we're going to be able to get more. We probably will. We probably will. But we don't know. I can't give you that as a guarantee. Now, outside of that, we also have some long way to wait. We don't know when we're going to be getting the next, the Dokkan Awakening of it. If we get it before the Supreme Fusion event, honestly, I'm going to tell you this right now. Unless you don't have any other good units, just don't Dokkan Awaken him. Hold him in your box. You know, unless you really, really don't have anyone else, hold him in your box. Wait for this event to come out. So that way you can farm up this guy so you can get him up to Super Attack 10. Bottom right dupe path unlocked. And if we ever get more of him, then fill in the rest of the dupe pads. One thing I will say is the rest of the dupe pads, maybe the top left will be worth it just because of the extra buffs. But in terms of base stats, it's never worth it because the base stats don't go up too much with the rest of the dupes. It goes up like 1,000, maybe 1,500 in a different location. Really, the bottom right gives you the most buffs, and the top left gives you the most additionals and crits and stuff like that. You can do the others if you want to. I'm not saying don't. But, you know, for a free-to-play unit that goes to an LR, we have to wait for his LR stats before making that decision. But if you don't mind and you were debating on whether you should do the bottom right dupe path or get him the Super Attack 20, do you want to put the orbs into it? If you do and you don't care and you want to put orbs into it, then bottom right dupe path it is. If you don't want to put orbs into him because you don't feel like he's going to be that great, then don't and give him the Super Attack 20 that way. That way you don't got to use Elder Kai's, but it's really up to you. I just wanted to make sure I got that out there. But when he becomes available on DokkanBattleBuilder.com, I will do a full review of him, and I'll do some team building with him and everything. It is pretty self-explanatory of who he is and who he's going to be linked with and what team he's going to be run on. But we're going to have to wait for the LR, for him to get Dope and Wake into LR for real information about that. But yeah, guys, that's it. I just want to talk about the card, let you know what the stats were going to be. Personally, I think you should do bottom right Dewpath if you feel like putting orbs into him. I did the bottom right Dewpath. I'm probably not going to put orbs into him right away. We're going to wait to see what happens with his actual LR variant. I still prefer to do the bottom right Dewpath because he is a free super attack 10 with this guy over here, but that's just me. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. I hope that was informative. Stay tuned because I'll be doing more information like this in the future. Thank you, and have a good one. Bye-bye.